Are you frustrated and confused by banana peels? Do you wish there was an easier way? Well, wish no longer, young sir. Introducing pre-peeled bananas in plastic wrappers. It's easy, convenient, and best of all, non-biodegradable. It's beautiful, sleek, slender, and just look at how small it is compared to this banana for size. No longer will you have to worry about slipping on banana peels. Just open up the wrapper, pull out your 105-calorie fruity delight, and enjoy. Yes, it's really that easy. Buy pre-peeled bananas in plastic wrappers today for the low cost of $9.99. Good morning, Art.
I'm Sam.
I'm Ben.
And I'm Zach.
Today is Friday, November 6th.
And today we are celebrating National Pre-Peeled Bananas in Plastic Wrappers Day.
Hold on. Didn't we can that idea during our last show in favor of Tuesday the 13th?
Zach, we're constantly on the edge of running out of ideas. You know we had to literally scrape the bottom of our creativity barrel at some point.
I, for one, think it's an excellent show idea. I mean, you know how difficult it is to open a banana.
You know, you're right, Ben. Forget the fact that monkeys have been opening them for over a millennia. Pre-peeling our bananas is the only way towards the utopian society that we all aspire to live in.
Yeah, that's what's been holding us back. Please stand for the pledge.
Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Here is Mr. Dotremont with your Friday morning message.
Good morning, Hart. This is Mr. Dotremont. I want to address next week as the Unity of Community Week for our district and Valley as a whole. This is no fun fact, so please let me have your attention on this very emotional and important matter. Most all of us know what occurred almost one short year ago. I won't talk about it, nor should you have to deal with it alone. We are here for you to listen and talk through the Saugus tragedy and want you to know that it was not okay what happened. We hope that something like that never happens again. That being said, let me tell you this. Each of you out there listening and watching right now has someone that cares about you. If you don't think that is true, I encourage you to participate in the many activities that we have planned for Hart and our district next week. Mrs. Fairborn talked about some of those yesterday, and all of your teachers have access to what is happening all next week during our Unity of Community events. The week will culminate with an assembly on Friday where students and staff talk about what occurred a year ago, what has occurred since, and what will occur in the future. I highly recommend you watch and take to heart. Dotremont, out.
Thank you, Mr. Dotremont. Here's your weekend weather forecast.
Today's high is going to be a high of 75 and a low of 48. Tomorrow, it's going to be a high of 55 and a low of 46. And on Sunday, it's going to be a high of 55 and a low of 37. This is Peter Harris from Hart TV, back to you in the studio.
Hart TV's own Ari Tillis caught up with some of the show choir members to find out more about the upcoming fall concert.
Hi everyone, I'm here with some amazing people I like to interview about show choir. We have an upcoming concert coming up this weekend, and I hope that we can interview them and get some great information, get everyone excited about the show. Here today I have Mrs. Anders, who is our lovely show choir director. I have Sophie and Olivia, who are our show choir presidents, and I have Cole, who is our social media director. Let's get into it. So here is Mrs. Anders, who is our show choir director, and I wanted to ask her some questions. Mrs. Anders, what is this show about?
Hi, Ari. This show is actually our annual Broadway show that we put together. It's the first concert that we put on every single year. And so we have sets from lots of different Broadway musicals, including Cats, In the Heights, Newsies, Dreamgirls. There's quite a bit of variety.
That sounds like so much fun. What is it like putting on a virtual show?
exhausting, actually. Thanks for asking. So basically, we started working on this in August, the second week of school, I think, maybe the third. And the kids have been recording vocals individually on a software program that we have and filming themselves, learning all the choreography on Zoom, and then filming themselves like in their backyards, in their living rooms, all over downtown Newhall. I mean, you name it. I don't think there's many places they haven't been to film. And so that was a giant undertaking. And then the second part of it is the editing side of things. So obviously this is a TV show, so there's editing involved in this as well. Our choreographers all learned how to video edit. Cole is actually doing a great deal of the video editing as well. And I've done all the sound editing. So we all have like a second career now in our video or audio engineering.
That sounds awesome. Now I'd like to move and ask a question to Sophie. Sophie, what is it like performing in a show like this?
I think that performing is definitely different than what we're used to, but it's definitely a new experience, and it's honestly kind of funny because there's a lot of bloopers you get from, you know, mouthing the wrong words / you know, falling on the floor, you know, a lot of different things that normally when you're performing, you kind of just move along, but when you're recording multiple takes, it's a bit different.
Speaking of that, Olivia, how is it different performing in a virtual setting compared to on stage, which we normally usually do?
I think that one of the main differences is when you're performing, you have the energy from your friends and from the audience helping you do your best performance, but when you're alone in your living room with a tripod, you have to really be self-motivated to continue if you realize, you know, that maybe wasn't my best take, but I'm really sick of filming this dance break over and over again. You have to really find it within yourself to keep being persistent, even though you aren't having the energy from the crowd and your teammates.
A very good insight into everything that we've had to do. And now for the most important question, Cole, how do people watch this amazing show that we're putting on?
So as you know, the show is going to be virtual, so it's going to be airing on twitch.com. You can find it at twitch.tv/heartshowchoir. It'll be airing tonight and tomorrow at 6:30 p.m. So remember that, twitch.tv/heartshowchoir. You can go in, watch it, comment, enjoy.
Can't wait, I'm so excited. I'm Ari Tillis, reporting for Heart TV. Back to you in the studio.
And now, the news. Calling all golfers, get your swing on and come out for the 2021 Heart Boys and Girls Golf Team Tryouts at Vista Valencia Golf Course. Girls' tryouts will be held on Tuesday, November 17th, and the boys' tryouts will be held on Wednesday, November 18th. All tryouts begin at 3 p.m. For more information, go to hearthighgolf.com or email Coach Lindberg at slindberg@heartdistrict.org.
Here are some of the upcoming college presentations. Go to your counselor's website for more information or the Zoom links.
University of Alabama will be on Monday, November 9th at 2 p.m.
FIDM virtual presentation is scheduled for Monday, November 16th.
And Washington State University will be on Wednesday, November 18th.
Attention, seniors. If you have not yet taken your senior portrait with O'Connor, please call as soon as possible to make an appointment. All seniors must have their pictures taken by November 7th. That's tomorrow.
What's your talent? Your family's talent? Your pet's talent? All it takes is 30 seconds. That's right, backed by popular demand, the SCV Wish Foundation and SCV TV present SCV's Virtual Talent Show, the Holiday Edition. Be part of the second SCV Community Virtual Talent Show hosted by Ed Masterson. This show will air on December 17th. It's free to enter, and yes, you can win some fabulous prizes. Also, the Heart District School with the most submissions will win an additional prize as well. So let's show them how much talent we have right here at Heart. Submissions will be accepted through November 27th.
And now it's time for today's
quote of the day.
My obsession is plastic packaging. It makes me sick. all the waste. Everything about it disappoints me. Theo James.
Well, that's it for our show.
Don't forget about Show Choir's fall concert tonight and tomorrow night.
Have a great National Pre-Peeled Bananas and Plastic Wrappers Day.
And
stay classy, Heart.